Good morning and welcome to the Triumphant Nation live stream. My name is Asia Matthews. I am president of the college ministry and I am glad you are joining us today. No matter what life may look like, we know that God is in control. Psalms 46 reminds us that he is an ever-present help in the time of trouble. If this is your first time tuning in, I would like to extend a special welcome to you. You could have picked any live stream, but you chose ours, and I am thankful for that. To our Triumphant Nation family, welcome back. You know what to do. Click the like and share. By sharing this worship experience, our mission is to spread the gospel and message of Jesus Christ throughout the world. Whether it be in person, at church, virtually on your phone, tablet, computer, or smart TV, make sure to follow us on all social media platforms. That's Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram by simply typing in Triumphant Nation. We appreciate you. Thank you again for joining. We are triumphant.
Everybody, wherever you are, let's lift up the name of Jesus, hallelujah, because he is worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be lifted. Come on, give him glory. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Everybody clap your hands. Come on, give God the glory wherever you are. Come on, lift him up because he is worthy. Because he is worthy of the praise. He is worthy of the glory. Has he been good to you? Hallelujah. Oh, bless that wonderful neighbor. Put your hands together. to stir up your atmosphere with praise. Stir up your atmosphere with giving God the glory. We came to give God praise on today. We came to give him glory. We came to give him honor because he's worthy of the praise. Now let's go here, y'all. God is a good God. I know God is a good God. Faithful God,
yes, he is.
Do you know that God is a faithful God?
Yes, he is.
I know God is a faithful God.
Yes, he is.
Oh, yes, he is.
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 A faithful God.
Yes, he is.
A holy God.
Yes, he is.
A righteous God.
Yes, he is.
Oh, yes, he is. I dare you to give him the glory. I dare you to give him the honor. And I dare you to give him the praise. That's it. Come on, use your instruments of praise. Use your hands and clap. Come on, use your voice and sing. Come on, come on. Now everybody just put those hands together and let's give God a hand clap of praise. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Put your hands together. Yes, Lord. Come on. Oh, yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. A good God. A mighty God. A holy God. A righteous God.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. A good God. He keeps on taking it to the next level, y'all. Yes, he is a good God, a mighty God, a holy God, a healing God. I know God is a good 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 God. Somebody give God the praise. I tell you to allow your mind to go back and think about how God is. He's a good God. He's a good God. He's a good God. He's a mighty God. He's a faithful God. He did not leave us. He did not forsake us. I tell you to give God some glory. Somebody gotta give give him the glory. Somebody ought to give him the praise. God has been a good God to us. He's been your provider. He's been your shelter. He's been your protector. He's been your keeper. I need you to shift and give God a worthy praise. God, you've been so good to me. I owe you this. I owe you a praise. I owe you glory. I owe you honor. Come on, somebody ought to give God a worthy praise. 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 A great praise for a great God. You ought to lift your hands. You ought to lift your voice. You ought to Shabbat God and give him the glory. Let the anointing in. Let the presence in. Let the power in. I dwell in the midst of the praises of my people. If you praise him, he'll come to you. If you praise him, he'll dwell in your midst. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, praise him just a little bit more. Praise him just a little bit more. Because I believe God is about to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power that works. If you want God to work, work your praise, work your worship, work your exaltation. Give God the glory. Glory, 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 glory. If I'm going to send the other Messiah, come on, drive it out with your praise. Come on, drive out everything that's not like God with your praise. Come on, let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow, let it flow. Yokes are being destroyed because of the anointing. Let God have his way. Let God have his way. Let God have his way. Glory, 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 glory. His word. His word. His word. His word. His word. Yes, yes, yes. That's it. Just give God praise. Give him worship and allow his presence to come in all the more. As you begin to lift your hands, hallelujah, into the atmosphere as a sign of surrender and as a sign of acknowledgement to Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, just begin to stretch your hands. If you're able to lift your hands, I invite you to lift your hands right now up into heaven. Hallelujah. Towards the mighty God that we serve. And just tell God, Lord, you've been so good to me, Lord. You've been so awesome to us, Lord. You've been so wonderful, God, and we just come back to tell you that we love you. Hallelujah. Not just with lip service, but with action. Hallelujah. Not just with words, God, but we put our physical body into it right now to say, Lord, I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. Hallelujah. Come on, that's it. That's it. Come on, just give them a little more. Give them a little more. Give them a little more. And honor the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords as we worship our Savior. Hallelujah. I lift my hands in total adoration unto you. You reign on the throne, for you are God and God alone. Because of you, my cloudy days are gone. Yeah, I can sing to you this song. I just want to say that I love you. me say I live. Somebody ought to just lift your hands unto God as we worship corporately. You reign. Reign on the throne, for you are God alone. Many days are gone. I can see to you is all. I just want to say that I love you more. Come on. You ought to have it by now, but I want every individual just to stretch out a little bit further. I love lift my hands in total adoration, not to you, only to you, my God.
God, we lift our hearts in worship to you, Lord.
That's
Come on, I worship.
I worship and adore.
Come on, wherever you are, just begin to lift your voice as we sing on one accord. More. Come on. Come on, the presence of the Lord is here. We just invite you to worship.
I love Jesus. Worship and adore.
I worship and adore.
Decree it in the atmosphere. Lord, I love you. One more time, let your voice and say to God, tell him right now, say, I love you,
Jesus.
I worship and adore.
I worship and adore you.
I just want to tell you as I lift my hands to you, Lord, yeah. Lord, I love you more than anything. I love you, Jesus.
Somebody, come on, just give God just a little bit more. Come on, break on through. A little bit more. I love you, Lord. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Come on, decree it out of your mouth. I love you, Jesus, more than anything. Yeah. I love you, God. I love you, Jesus. I love you with my life, God. I love you with my heart, Jesus. I love you with my mind, God. I love you with my soul, God. I magnify you. I lift you up, God. I love you. Come on. I love you, Jesus. You're worthy, Lord. Yeah. I love you, God. You've been right there. You've done so much. You've done so much, God. And we love you. Oh, oh God, oh, God, we worship you. Oh God, we honor you. God, we magnify you because there's truly nobody like you, God. Hey, God. Oh, yes, nobody. Oh God, you're so worthy, Lord. And we honor you, God, and we magnify you, Lord. Hallelujah, because there's nobody like you, Lord. Come on, wherever you are, just begin to clap your hands and give God the praise. Hallelujah. That's it. Come on, give him the glory and the honor as we prepare to welcome to the podium a phenomenal man of God. Our senior pastor, the one and only Bishop Fred Matthews II, in Jesus.
You are tuned in to Triumphant Church in Nashville, Tennessee, a place where you can connect, grow, and serve with other believers. And now it is time to experience a word from our senior pastor and founder, the Honorable Bishop Fred Matthews, Jr.
Bless his name, hallelujah. Come on, let's just take a moment and worship him right there. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, no matter where you're at, just take about 30 seconds and bless the name of Jesus. Let a pure sound of worship come out of your mouth. Oh, yes, God. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. It's for what he did on Calvary's cross. Oh, we bless him. 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 Come on, lift up your voice. Lift up your hands. Lift your heart to the Lord. Oh, we worship you, God. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Lord. We bless your name. We bless your name, Lord. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we bless the name of the Lord. We thank him. We bless him. Because Jesus went to Calvary. I want you to just play that stanza a little bit more. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. My God, sometimes you just got to really think on that thing. That if it wasn't for what he did on Calvary's cross, hallelujah, we would all be on our way to hell. Come on, praise team. Let's sing that again. Jesus went. Jesus went.
Jesus went.
There you go.
To Calvary.
Come on. Those of you that are even watching right now, come on, sing it with us. Come on, that's love right there. Come on, Jesus went to Calvary. Story. Come on.
The story is.
Come on, praise him.
3 days later, he rose again.
Come on.
That's not.
Come on, that's not how the story is. To think about that. I want you to think about it. We bless your holy name. Truly there is none like you. We worship you and we adore you. Truly that's what this experience is all about this morning. The fact that Jesus died for you. The fact, amen, that he saw you in your condition and know that man needed a savior. Hallelujah. Even before you were formed in the belly, hallelujah, the Lord knew you, and he knew what the condition would be, and he died on that cross, and we thank him. This morning, as we prepare for the word of the Lord, in the book of Numbers, chapter number 4, verse number 13. The book of Numbers, chapter number 4, verse number 13. Thank you, praise team. That I love you more than anything in the book. book of Numbers, chapter number 4, verse number 13, it says, "And they shall take away the ashes from the altar and spread a purple cloth thereon." I'm just going to park it right there. "And they shall take away the ashes from the altar and spread a purple cloth thereon." Going to put a pin right there, and I'm going to talk to you this morning from the subject, build God an altar. Build God an altar. Glory to God. My brothers and sisters, biblically, when we talk about the origin of altars, it goes clearly back where we see our first altar in the book of Genesis. It is where you will recall that Noah built an altar to offer sacrifices after the flood. In Genesis chapter number 8 and 20, the Bible says that Noah built an altar unto the Lord and took of every clean beast and of every clean fowl and offered burnt offerings on the altar. Now realize that the altar was used to make animal sacrifices to the Lord. The purification of the altar was accomplished by the sprinkling of the animal blood upon the altar. Altars were erected in places where the Lord had accomplished some great work or where some prophetic message would begin to take place. Later, the Israelites had altars in the tabernacle in the desert. And once Solomon's temple was built, that's where we first see altars in the temple. As such, we have today's church where we know the pulpit area is a sacred place. This goes back to Solomon's temple where the altar is that special place of prayer, of deliverance, of worship. We want to make sure that we don't destroy what the altar was meant to do. Many people have transformed the altar or traded it in for performance venues. Many people have traded the altar in as a place to give themselves glory, nothing more than a secular stage. But you must remember, the altar is a sanctified place. When you think about the altar of the Lord, this is the place where somebody goes from doom to glory. The altar is the place where folks are delivered from things that have had them bound. And the Lord gave very detailed instructions about where the altar would be placed and how it would be built. Those of you who read your Bibles know that the function of the altar was to give that sacrifice and that worship. Anytime we come to the altar, we know that it is a sacred place, and special care had to be made to keep the altar holy. Can somebody say holy? It's a holy place. And part of that special care, when you look back at where altars were first erected, was to get rid of the ashes that had accumulated on a daily basis. Well, you say, what do you mean getting rid of the ashes? Understand that when altars were first erected, they were erected with wood. They were erected with fire to represent the flame of the Holy Ghost. One of the jobs of the priest of the Old Testament was to never let the flame on the altar go out. The flame had to keep burning because the flame is what represents the presence of the Lord. So now here's what God has dropped into my spirit, that many of us need to go get a proper worship position, and we need to scrape off some stuff that's causing the fire to go out. Many of us need to go back to that worship position, amen, and get rid of the stuff that's causing us to miss our deliverance on the altar, causing the fire to be dim. Some of you are wondering why, glory to God, that you can't get the breakthrough that you need. It's probably because you're trying to come to God for a blessing, but you're holding on to some stuff that you don't have no business holding on to. The Lord wants a clean temple. The Lord wants people that wants all of him and not some of him. You want God to bless your finances, but you're still playing the lottery. You want God to bless your finances, but you won't tithe. You want God to fix your marriage, but you won't stay out of folks' inbox that you're not married to. Come on, you want to be used by God to minister in church on Sunday, but on an everyday basis, you're not living the life that God has caused you to live. Come on, somebody, you want the new car, you want the new house, the new job, you want the blessings, but the blessings may be delayed because God is waiting on you to scrape the ashes off the altar so he can give you what he needs. Somebody ought to say, it's time for me to get rid of the ashes off the altar. It's time for me to get rid of the stuff that is trying to make the flame go out. I don't know, when I think about ashes, I think about a barbecue grill. Have anybody ever cooked out on a grill before and you accidentally dropped a piece of meat down in the slots of the grill? All the brothers know what I'm talking about. Sometime it'll go on down through there. And be honest, if ain't nobody looking, you probably took the little tongues and put that meat up out the charcoal, fished it out, put it back on the fire, and finished cooking it. And then, you know, you took it off the grill, put it on a plate, and served it to your guests. You know, you knew not to take that little charcoal piece there. Amen. When you ate, you just went on around that crusty piece because you knew how it was going to taste. Well, guess what? God wants to feed you with the goodness of his word. But before you can enjoy the goodness of his word, you've got to remove the ashes from off of what is taking place. Let me talk about this ashes thing real quick, because here is what I have learned about ashes. I want to drop in your spirit three quick things about ashes. First of all, I've learned that ashes are bitter. Somebody say bitter. Nobody in their right mind wants to eat ashes. Why? Because ashes are nasty. Ashes are bitter. Watch this. Some of us have been eating ashes of painful relationships. Some of us have been eating ashes of experiences so long that now we're bitter all the time with everybody we come in contact with. A bitter person is a dangerous person. A bitter person is a complaining person. That's why the Apostle Paul told us, it was in Hebrews chapter number 12, verse number 15, he said, look diligently, lest any man shall fail of the grace of God, lest any take the root of bitterness springing up, troubling you, and therefore you may be defiled. In other words, what Paul is telling us is that the root of bitterness will not only defile us, but it will defile the folks around us. It will affect your children. It will affect the people. You're wondering why people are distancing themselves, because no one wants to be around somebody who is always bitter. When we feed on the ashes, that is to say, when we allow cruel things that have been done to us yesterday to affect how we function today, it's time to clear up those ashes. Come on, we cannot become bitter, not only within ourselves, saints of God, but to every person that comes into our lives. Have you ever been so angry and frustrated by a situation that you snapped at somebody who had absolutely nothing to do with what happened to you? Some of you have snapped on your spouse off of what your boss did at work. Some of you all have punished your children because you're mad at your spouse. Some of us, amen, even then kicked the poor dog, glory to God, because we've allowed, amen, the root of bitterness to defile us. But you ought to turn to somebody real quick and say, I didn't do nothing to you. Don't take your stuff out on me. Come on, stop snapping at me because of what other folks did. Don't take out on me what happened in your last relationship. Come on here. All because you fooled around with a thug, a baby daddy that was a dog, don't mean you ought to bring it over into what God is doing in your life. Can the church shout hallelujah? My brothers and sisters, I've discovered that the enemy loves to keep you in the bounds of bitterness. But I've come to minister to you on today to tell you that bitterness should not be a part of the believer. Jesus said that the thief comes, my God, to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But he said that I've come that you might have life and that you may have it more abundantly. Have you ever noticed how the enemy attacks you? Glory to God, when you've just had an encounter with God. We're in the midst of a consecration. And if you're really consecrating, understand that there's an attack that comes when you're trying to get close to God. Satan don't bother you as long as you're just sitting around watching the football game or at the mall shopping or relaxing on the front porch or on the backyard lounge chaser. No, he waits till when you get out of that good Bible study. Come on, when you just finished getting your praise on. Come on, when you just made up in your mind that I'm going to forgive those who hurt me, that did me wrong. When you made up in your mind to stop running around and that you're going to be a good husband or a good wife or a good dad or a good mother. That is when the enemy tries to carry you back to the place that God has brought you from. But I'm here to tell you, you got to get rid of the ashes of bitterness. Come on, I wish you'll turn to somebody real quick and say, you cannot feed on those ashes. Glory to God, those are bitter ashes. Have I got a witness here? Not only, amen, do you need to think about that, but number two, you got to understand that ashes are not only bitter, but ashes provide you no strength whatsoever. Saints of God, there is absolutely no nutritional value in ashes. Matter of fact, you'll grow weaker day by day if you feed on ashes. It was David in the book of Psalms 102 that says, for I have eaten ashes like bread and mingled my drink with weeping. In other words, David was saying that I become so busy dealing with yesterday's junk that I forgot to eat the bread of life. Sometimes you can get so consumed with what got to happen. How am I going to make this move? How am I going to get more money? How am I going to take care of my children? That it affects your spiritual life on a daily basis. Give me a little bit more monitor so I can preach this thing out of field. Amen. When we fail to eat the fresh bread of life every day, we begin to decline. Child of God, you need to eat spiritually every day. Somebody say every day. Just like your body needs nourishment every day, your spiritual man needs nourishment every day. And I'm not talking about just on a consecration either, but afterwards, every single day, you need to feed your spirit. You need to feed it the word of God. You need to feed it with prayer. You need to feed it with worship music. Come on, I may have been fed yesterday in the natural, but you best believe I need a meal today. Come on here. I just like in the spiritual sense, I may have shouted last Sunday, but I got to get my praise on today. Can somebody shout hallelujah? Come on. I may have heard a good word last week, but I want to know today, is there a word from the Lord? Why don't you high five your neighbor and say, neighbor, I need a word. Come on, tell them I need nourishment today. Come on. Yesterday is gone. I need something today. And the problem with a lot of places, even of worship, is that they're trying to feed on yesterday's glory. glory. They're still on the same program, the same format as the 1980s. Amen. And wondering why there is no fresh glory. But somebody say, I need a word today. I hate to bring in a secular artist, but it was Janet Jackson that said, what have you done for me lately? I need God to touch me today. I need God to save my children today. I need God to deliver my mind today. I need God to heal my body today. I need breakthroughs today. Somebody ought to clap your hands and say, I need strength today. I'm not talking about when I first got saved. I'm not talking about when I first came out the tarrying room. I'm not talking about when I first came off the altar, but I need God to fill me all over again. Somebody ought to clap your hands and shout glory in this place. Come on, church, somebody shout glory in this place. Give me a little bit more monitor, John. I need a little bit more. Glory to God, because, amen, help me, Holy Ghost. Amen. I'm reminded of Exodus chapter number 16, when the Lord gave Moses instructions concerning manna. Amen. Y'all will remember, amen, the Lord had told Moses when they were in the midst of the wilderness, he said, I'm going to send down manna, and all I need you to do is take enough of that manna to feed on today. He said, don't let any of that manna stick around until tomorrow. But some folks got greedy, because the Bible lets us know that some folks had ignored the instructions, and they had decided that they were going to keep some manna overnight. And the Bible says that when they decided to keep that manna overnight, night, that worms got in it and that it began to stink. I wish I had some Bible readers here. What am I trying to say here is that yesterday's manna breeds worms and it stinks. And if we try to eat it, it will make us sick. Some of us are eating the wrong stuff. That's why you can't afford to be in everybody's church. You can't be on everybody's live stream. Everybody ain't got the right type of food. Everybody ain't preaching the right sound doctrine. There comes a time where you got to get rid of that name it and claim it junk that will tear you up and get a real word that's going to satisfy your spirit. Today's manna is fresh and it strengthens you. Saints of God, you need to make up in your mind. I feel the Holy Ghost here. That despite yesterday's stinky situation, that today, hallelujah, I'm going to seek a fresh anointing in my life. That leads me to my third point here, is that eating the wrong ashes will make you sick. There are some folks that are spiritually sick because they are eating at the wrong table. There are some folks that are spiritually sick. Glory to God, because they're just feeding on concerts rather than the pure word of God. There are some folks that are spiritually sick because they're running from prophet to prophet that really only want their money, but they're not ministering out of a pure heart. But saints, you need to make up in your mind today that despite all that's going on, that I'm going to seek a fresh anointing in my life. Somebody ought to say, I need a fresh anointing. Come on, let me preach my way on out of here. Somebody say, I need a fresh anointing. Come on, yesterday's manna ain't gonna work for me. But I'm building God an altar in my life. One that is not loaded with ashes. One that is not loaded with bitterness. And today I'm gonna take it a little bit higher. Because I need to build God an altar. I need a new level in my relationship with God. Is there anybody here that can say, I got to go higher? Is there anybody watching today that can say, I got to go a little bit deeper in my walk with God? Come on here. I got to build God an altar. High five your neighbor and say, it's time to build God an altar. I need an altar that won't allow folks to take me where I don't want to go. I need an altar that will not allow me to go to the wrong bedroom when my flesh act up. I need an altar that won't let low self-esteem come and take me there. Come on here. I'm getting a proper position so that I can hear a word from God. Somebody say, I got to build God an altar. Come on, because I'm going to get a fresh anointing. And that's the word that I have for somebody today, is that God said he's going to give you a fresh anointing. I know you may be in your bedroom right now, but I want you to know that you can build God an altar right where you are. You might be in your living room right now, but you can build God an altar. Now, I'm talking to some folks that don't need a church building to enjoy the presence of the Lord. Is there anybody here that need a fresh anointing? I dare you to lift your hands and say, I need a fresh anointing, God. I need a fresh anointing, God, to deal with yesterday's fools. I need a fresh anointing so I can deal with yesterday's unpaid bills. Somebody lift those hands and say, Lord, endow me with a fresh anointing right now. I know what may be going on with the pandemic. I know what may be going on in folks' money. I know what may be going on with civil unrest. But I want you to know that God will give you a fresh anointing. Come on, if you need a fresh anointing, I dare you to receive it right now. But you got to get rid of the ashes off that altar. You got to get rid of the stuff that's holding you back. You got to get rid of the drugs and the alcohol. You got to give me some more monitor, John. You got to get rid of the blackened mouths. You got to get rid of the lesbian friends. You got to get rid of, come on, the wrong type of people. Because the Bible says that evil communication corrupts good manners. Thank you, some. High five your neighbor and say, neighbor, this is the time for you to clean off your altar. Everybody can't go where God is calling you to. And you got to make up your mind that whatever it costs, I'm going to build God a fresh altar. I can't let my altar be ashy. I can't let my altar be full of dust and ash. I don't need an ashy altar, but I need an oily altar. I need the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Somebody listening to me right now, you ought to stand on your feet because you're at a crossroads. You're tired of being hungry. You're tired of being weak. You're tired of being thirsty. God is saying, it's time for you to drink from the well that never runs dry. I dare you to open your mouth and start blessing God. I dare dare you to open your mouth and start blessing them right now, because God told me to tell you it's time to get out of your present state and build God a fresh altar. Well, how am I going to build him a fresh altar? God said, start praising me. How am I going to build him a fresh altar? You got to open up your mouth and say, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble thereof shall be glad. God told me to tell you, get off that present state of mind and go to a new level. I dare you to lift your hands and say, it's my time to start going higher. It's my time to prophesy. It's my time to worship on a new level. It's my time to go through another dimension. God told me to tell you, get ready for a fresh strength. Get ready for a fresh anointing. High five your neighbor and say, neighbor, I dare you to praise him right where you're at. If you're in your living room, I dare you to usher out a praise. If you're in your kitchen, God said, start praising him. Start building him an altar. Because on this altar, God's getting ready to pour it out. Lift your hands and say, pour it out, God. Pour it out on me, God. I want to be drunk. I'm not done yet. I want to be drunk with the Holy Ghost. I want to feel God's presence one more time. Is it anybody here that's tired of church as usual? Is it anybody here that's tired of predictable moves? But I dare you to shake your neighbor's hand like you're going to shake it off and say, I squeeze a fresh anointing in your life. Say, I squeeze religion out of your life. I squeeze prophetic oil in your life. I dare you to give God praise, because God says, with your next praise, I'm taking you to a new level. With your next praise, I'm opening up financial doors. With your next praise, I'm opening up marriage doors. With your next praise, loans are being approved. With your next praise, your children can get saved. With your next praise, I'll heal your body. I dare you to receive it by faith. I dare you to praise him right now. I dare you to clap your hands right now. I dare you to open your mouth right now. On the count of three, God said, when you praise him and you build him an altar, he's going to send the fire. Are y'all ready? One, get ready. Stir your spirit up. Two, get ready. Get ready to open your mouth. And when I count to three, God said, go for broke. And watch me release miracles in your life. One, two, three, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Release. Release the fire, God. Release the fire. Release the double satana, double satana. Hey! Open up your mouth. I hear the Lord say, release. I hear him say, release. Come on, your children are on the line. Come on, your spiritual life is on the line. Come on, come on your altar. Oh, I feel him, I feel him. Come on, do it by faith.
Don't let nothing stop you. Come on, I know you're not in a church full of people, but God said, I'll touch you right where you're at. Come on, praise him, praise him, praise him. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him, praise him, praise him. Come on, praise him, praise him. Come on, praise him, praise him. Come on, set there, y'all. Come on, build God that altar. That's it. Come on, praise him. Whoa. That's it. Go deeper. That's what I hear the Holy Ghost say. Go deeper in your worship. Go deeper right now. Right now, the most. Come on, believer. Come on, Holy Ghost filled believer. The Lord said deeper. The Lord said, come on, praise team. The Lord said deeper. Come on, musicians. Go deeper. He said, prophesy on those instruments. Come on, praise team. Deeper. Deeper. Come on, body of believers. You're building God a new altar. The double side. Send the fire. Send the fire. Come on. Can't nobody do this for you. Come on, you don't need no cheerleader. Open your own mouth. Every woman, every boy, every girl. Come on, your mama can't do it for you. Your daddy can't do it for you. Come on, open your mouth and bless them, bless them, bless them. Come on, God is burning some stuff out of people. That's what he's doing on this altar. God is burning out some addictions. Come on, he's burning off that pornography demon. Come on, he's burning off that lust demon. Come on, set it on fire, God. He's burning out anger issues. Set it on fire, God. Set it on fire. He's burning out adultery. He's burning out fornication. Come on, he's doing it right now. I dare you to praise him for it. I dare you to go in warfare for it. He's burning out depression. He's burning out loneliness. He's burning it out. He's burning it out. Yes, he is. You got to see it by faith. You got to walk in it by faith. He's burning out poverty. He's burning it out. He's burning out generational curses. Somebody say, burn it out, Lord, burn it out. Come on, that's it. Worship him. Worship him. Right there, worship him. Come on, lift your voice and worship him. Come on, every Holy Ghost filled believer. Release it. Release it. Come on, there's a purging going on right now. There's a purging. You're at the altar right now. You're at the altar right now. There's a purging going on. There's a purging. I see it in the spirit. Some folks are being freed from stuff that you've dealt with for years. God said there's a purging. Some of you have been in the same cycle, but God said he's breaking that chain. There's a purge going on. There's a purge. It's not go get on your children. Come on, get into this worship right there. Come on, just release it. Release the Holy Ghost. Come on, speak in tongues in those mics. I feel warfare. Speak in tongues. Prophesy on those instruments. Somebody, I don't know where you're watching from, but God has put that suicide spirit. It's being broke right now. Come on, push in the spirit. Push in the spirit. Push in the spirit. Come on. Come on, even the media team. Begin to worship God.
Hey, don't be so caught up in ministry that you're working, that you miss your moment. Hey, come on, the arm of him, the cameraman. Come on, release worship. The presence of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here. The power of God is here. And he's freeing somebody. He's freeing you. He's freeing you. That's it. God can fill you with the Holy Ghost if you'll just be obedient and start worshiping him. And I promise you, the more you want God, the more you draw to God, the more he'll draw to you. Oh, God fills people in the middle of worship all the time. Somebody, you might be at home in your bedroom and you want the Holy Ghost. I dare you to just start praying and worshiping God right now. Hey, he will change your English to a prayer tongue. Yes, he will. Do it, do it. Let him fill you right now. Let him fill you. Come on, I need every prayer intercessor. I need my online ministers. Right where you're at, to just start bombarding heaven. Somebody's getting saved right now. Somebody's getting healed right now. Whoa! Yes. That's it, worship. I can't see you, but I feel you in the spirit. Somebody's breaking through in the spirit. Somebody's been holding on to some hurt. And I see God freeing you in the spirit. He's freeing you from the pain. He's freeing you from the abuse, from the molestation. God is saying you're being freed right now. Just worship him. Because where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There's freedom in worship. The enemy can't go where we're at right now. This is your time. This is your time to build God an altar. This is your time for a fresh breakthrough. We've all had failures. We've all had mistakes. But I hear the Lord say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. That's it. Somebody get the breakthrough. You've been stressed, anxiety, frustration, but just start worshiping him right there, right there, right there. The Lord said the things that plagued you will plague you no more. Hallelujah. And God may not even change certain situations, but he'll change you in the situation and give you strength like you never thought that you had. My God, will you take 30 seconds right now and get into that zone with God? Get into that space with God. Just almost forget everybody that's around you right now. And I want you to tap in. I want you to tap in. You need this touch from God on this altar. On this altar, right there, right there. No performance, no games, no gimmicks. You and God. That's it. That's it. You are a child of God. You are not defeated. You're more than a conqueror. I speak to the giant on the inside of you. I prophesy new levels in your life. I come against the hurt and the pain that's trying to overtake you. The guilt, the fear. Send it back to the pits of hell. All of that is nothing but ashes that's trying to flood your altar so your fire don't burn. But we clean off those ashes. Pain and bitterness and broken relationships, bad parenting, folks that have abandoned you, folks that should have been protecting you. We clear it off. We clear off those bitter ashes right now. The fresh fire of God is moving upon you right now. Somebody's receiving strength right now. Somebody is having an encounter with the Holy Ghost. Oh, I just heard the Lord say that he's healing somebody's body right now. In the name of Jesus. Woo! He's working through your bloodstream. He's working through complications. My God, the Lord is doing it. The Lord is doing it. He's healing a marriage right now. Oh! Yes, he is. Yes, he is. God told me to tell you, he hears your worship. He hears your worship. He sees your heart right now. That's it. Even if you're not screaming out of your mouth, you scream with your heart right now. And you open up your heart by faith. Say, create in me a clean heart and renew the right spirit in me. If you need to repent, repent right now. The presence of the Lord is so open right now. God, I repent from every area where I failed you. God, I come running. I come running. Whoo! As the deer, come on, panteth after the water brook, so does my soul pant after thee. Oh, God. Oh, yes, God. Yes, 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 he's doing it. That's it. If somebody want to be saved right now, there's nothing like salvation. There's nothing in that world worth holding on to that should cost you or make you even question whether you're ready for a relationship with Jesus right now. There's no man, no woman, no drug, no addiction. Nothing should be able to separate you from the love of God. Now the Lord say the only way that a person can be saved is if he draw them and if he touches them. And he says he'll do it. Now there are some watching right now, you don't feel a thing. You haven't opened up yourself enough to feel anything. But then there are some right now that your spirit is open and you're ready for a closer walk with him. You're ready. You're ready. Now here's the instructions according to the scripture. That the day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Don't harden your heart. Well, I gotta wait till I do this and I gotta wait till I do that or next week. No, no, no. He said the day that you hear his voice, don't harden your, you can't manipulate God and put him on an appointment for next week. When God is moving upon you, move right then and there. Who needs healing right now? Who needs deliverance right now? Who needs salvation right now? Who needs a peace of mind right now? If you're watching right now, I want you to type the word eternal life. If you need one of our prayer warriors to connect with you and pray with you today, not tomorrow, to pray with you today, type the word eternal life. If you want to be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, type the word eternal life. If you have a situation going on, maybe you got caught, maybe you are in the midst of turmoil, just type the word eternal life. And our prayer warriors will reach out to you and we'll pray with you. Whether it's giving your life to Christ, whether it's connecting with this ministry. Come on. The Lord wants a yes from you. Oh, my heart says yes. The Lord is waiting on you right now. With tears in your eyes, the Lord said, come on. I know it's been heavy, but come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Don't wait another minute.
surrender your spirit.
We surrender.
Come on.
Rather that be those who want to join our ministry. No matter where you're at, you can be a part of the Triumphant Nation. No matter what state you live in, we're all virtual right now. So you're certainly welcome. Those of you who just needed prayer, I pray for you in the name of the Lord Jesus. And I believe the Lord is doing a new work in your life right now. Receive that. Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Amen and amen. We've offered God our praise, our worship. Some of you have just offered God your life. That's the best thing you can ever do. That's the best thing you can ever do. And I know there are some folks on this line right now that are saying, that can testify that every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Now I challenge you to not let the ashes build up on the altar you have erected today. So when somebody come with the wrong stuff, say, nope, I'm cleaning off those ashes. You're not gonna corrupt my altar. When you get that wrong text message or that wrong inbox, the Holy Spirit will tell you that that ain't no good. Clean those ashes off. When you go to work and they say something to try to throw your day off, no, I'm cleaning those ashes off my altar. When that family member do something way in left field and it try to take you to the wrong place, say, no, I'm cleaning those ashes off that altar because I need my fire to continue to burn. I need my worship to go to another level. I need my preaching to go to another level. I need my walk with God to go to another level. And it can't go if I let that mess build up on my altar. So that's my challenge to you this week. Keep your altar clean so that God, the fire of God, will continue to burn in your life. This morning as we get ready to offer God our sacrifice monetarily, as we offer him our tithe, what a special time of worship. Tithing is a heart issue. It's a faith issue. It's a sacrifice. It's a reason that God uses money to test us. Because he knows that folks will lift their hands. They'll do that. You know, folks will run around the church and worship. But God say it also come a time when you got to give something so that my work can go forward, so that I can bless you financially. He said, bring all the tithe into the storehouse, that it'll be meat in my house. And he said, prove me now herewith, if I will not open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. There's a song that says, everything's gonna be all right. And that's what I want you to know. Everything, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. I feel that in my spirit. Can somebody just touch somebody right next to you? Say, I got a feeling that everything is gonna be all right. Now look at them real good and say, that means your money too, neighbor. Say, that means your money too. I wish I had some folks that need a financial breakthrough. And I just believe that when you sow your tithe and offering, when you sow it right now, hallelujah, we gonna give together. Get your debit card out. Get ready. You can text TC Nashville to 77977. Or you can find us on Cash App at TC Nashville. That's T as in Tom, C as in Cat, and the word Nashville. You'll see a purple cross. I want you to sow knowing that everything is going to be all right. I want you to give in faith. Oh, but preacher, I got this and I got that and this is due. That's why I want you to sow. That's why don't let the enemy make you rob God. The devil is a liar. We're going to minister this song to you as you're giving right now. As you're giving information is on the screen now. Come on, I've got a feeling.
I've got a feeling.
Come on.
Everything's gonna be alright. I've got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright.
Come on and pray. The Lord loves a cheerful giver. As you're going to Cash App, as you're texting your gift, yep, jobs may be in jeopardy, but it's going to be all right.
Jesus,
come on.
Jesus told me everything's going to be all right. Oh, Jesus, Jesus told me everything's
going to
be all right.
Come on, so. The enemy will not creep into my money. My days of debt are over. I'm not dependent on the money. I'm not dependent on playing numbers. The devil is a liar. Come on, let's have some church.
Jesus told me.
Put those hands together. The Lord loves Jesus, a cheerful giver.
Jesus told me
everything.
Everything's gonna be alright.
It's gonna be alright.
Be alright.
Come on, breakthrough, breakthrough.
Be alright.
Come on.
Everything's gonna be alright.
He said it, everything.
as you praise, he's gonna fix it. It's gonna be, it's gonna be, it's gonna be alright.
Come on, praise him. It's gonna be alright. Somebody ought to receive that word in your spirit. Just touch yourself real quick. Say, everything is gonna be alright. Quit worrying. Quit worrying. It's gonna be alright. The marriage is gonna be alright. Your money is gonna be alright. Your children are gonna be alright. Oh yes, receive it. We're gonna give our triumphant declaration. Woo, put that on the screen for me. We're gonna give our triumphant declaration. While you're praising him, while you're praising him. Say, I am a tither. And a giver.
And
I am blessed. Beyond measure. I have more than enough. I am living in my overflow. I am living in Ephesians 3:20 for the rest of my life. I am triumphant.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is so awesome in all of his ways. And we glorify him. We magnify him. There may be somebody even online right now. You need to connect with a church home. You want to connect with a ministry. Hallelujah. That's moving kingdom things forward. I came to announce that Triumphant is the place for you. So if you're online and you want to connect with this family, with the Triumphant Nation, just connect. Just connect by typing in the comments, join, and somebody from our ministry team will reach out to you in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And we give God the glory for that mighty word on today. We give God praise for that awesome work. Hallelujah. And I feel that God is doing something abundant in his people. And we give Hayedebekoshaya, and we give him the praise, and we give him the praise, and we give him the glory, because there is nobody like our God. As we prepare to dismiss, hallelujah, with our hearts raised unto God, may the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent one from another, in Jesus' name. We go and be blessed in the name of the Lord, and we are triumphant.
Battle's already won.
The battle's already won.
There's a greater power.
There's a greater power.
Now come on, clap some hands like this.
I will not be defeated, for I know that there's victory for me. I've already won because of the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Yes. If I say it, I can see it, claim it, it's already mine.